Thank y'all for tuning in to another episode of Crime Chronicles. On today's episode, I'm going to cover the highly profile case of Raymond Christopher Sharp. 1996, Portland, Oregon. Alicia Grundy, age 16, a 10th grader, was on her way to do what most 10th graders do, go hang out at the mall. While walking to the mall, Raymond Sharp, age 30, pulled up in his fancy car. He told Grundy he was a record producer and offered to take her to dinner. Grundy got in the car and the two headed to Grundy's home for her to get clothes for the date. Grundy got her clothes and the two drove off to what was supposed to be a date. But the car headed towards California, and that's when Sharp told her he was a pimp and she was gonna prostitute for him. And if she didn't, he knew where her family lived and would kill them. From then on, it was a life of prostitution, walking the streets, living in hotels. For 14 years, the beating came when the money didn't come. Grundy knew she had to get out the day that Sharp made her pick her punishment, waterboarding or pistol whipping. Grundy ran away, but she got a call from Sharp. He was in Oregon with Grundy's little sister and told her if she didn't come back to him, he would have Grundy's little sister prostituting. Grundy did go back to Sharp, and she paid for it. He beat her so bad, her face was unrecognizable. Sharp beat her so bad, he thought he had killed her. He cut off her hair and threw her in the trunk of his car. He took her to his house and tied her up in the closet and left her there for 3 days. July 2011. Court record states that Las Vegas police received a call about a hysterical and partially nude woman that was bleeding from the head. She was going around banging on doors throughout the Northwest neighborhood asking for help. Grundy heard Sharp loading up his gun and she ran outside into the arms of the police as they arrived on the scene. Grundy told the police that she was a prostitute and Sharp was her pimp. She told the police that Sharp had become angry and pistol whipped her because she was trying to quit prostitution and had a new boyfriend. She further stated that she tried to run away, but Sharp came out and dragged her back into the house. Once back in the house, Sharp began to load up a gun and threatened to kill her if the police came. Sharp had left the house on foot jogging to escape before the police got there. He was apprehended a short time later, a couple of blocks from his residence. Sharp told the officers that he had gone to get a bottle of water and did not know what had happened to Grundy. Sharp, at the time, was a registered sex offender. He was arrested and ultimately charged with 13 separate counts, including 9 counts resulting from altercation with Grundy and 4 counts resulting from stripped vehicles found at his house. Sharp stood trial for these charges. Grundy was the prosecution's key witness. With DNA evidence and testimony from Grundy, Sharp was found guilty of 13 felony charges. Some of the charges were kidnapping with the use of a deadly weapon, burglary, living from the earnings of a prostitute, pandering with force, and assault with a deadly weapon. July 2012. Clark County Judge Alyssa Kaddish found Raymond Christopher Sharp, age 47, was a habitual offender and sentenced him to 13 life sentences. While serving his time at High Desert State Prison, Sharp was hit with a civil lawsuit by Grundy.
Her prostitute goes public after getting her pimp locked up for life. She sued him for everything he owned, this after he kidnapped her at age 16 and forced her to work as a sex slave.
Grundy became the first person to successfully sue her pimp while he was serving a life sentence. After 3 years of court battles, the judge awarded Grundy 4 houses, acres in land, and $3 million in cash, a total of $4.1 million judgment for 14 years of torture. The story doesn't end there. In 2014, the FBI opened an investigation on several police officers who were suspected of conspiring with sex traffickers. One of the officers, Detective Chris Boffman, cooperated in a criminal conspiracy with Molly Mall, an escort kingpin, music producer, and reality show star from VH1, Love & Hip Hop. Boffman used his authority to eliminate Molly Mall competitors, including Sharp. Molly Mall would give Boffman money monthly and supply him with prostitutes. Sharp filed an appeal. In the appeal, he stated that Detective Boffman had relationships with some of his prostitutes, and that Detective Boffman had an affair with the lead prosecutor on Sharp case, District Attorney Liz Mercer. Mercer and Boffman would later get married, which drew more suspicion. Sharp also stated Detective Boffman was sleeping with various witnesses who were not only witnesses, prostitutes, but victims in the cases. Sharp stated Detective Boffman was directing their testimony and having them fall in love with him. Detective Boffman was a star among vice cops. He was part of a special unit that was created in 2008 that went after high-profile pimps. Pimps who had made a lot of money in the sex business in Las Vegas, but seemed untouchable. Detective Boffman profile grew inside and outside the department, and that helped him get a 3-book deal with a publisher. In 2013, he left the department to be a part of a television show. When the production failed for the TV show, Boffman tried to get rehired by the department, but wasn't reinstated due to allegation that he was sleeping with prostitutes who were witnesses in cases. Boffman would go on to work at a strip club running the limousine stand. The FBI investigations are still pending to this day. They have requested a great deal of information from Metro Police Department. Deputy DA Liz Mercer has been taken off any involvement in the case due to her being married to Boffman. At this time, she is not accused of any wrongdoing in this case. The District Attorney Office will have no involvement in this case during the appeal process due to all the allegations. As of today, Sharp is still serving his 13 life sentences at High Desert State Prison. He is still waiting on his appeal process. Thank y'all for watching. Please click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it. Leave a comment, click the thumbs up button, and share it.